stories making headlines. Uganda's LGBTI seek audience with the Pope. South Africa organizes first transgender visibility day in Africa. Medical fund for author Binyavanga set up. The news in detail. Gay rights activists in Uganda have asked for a private audience with the Pope Francis when he visits the East African nation this weekend. Rights activist Frank Mugisha, the director of Sexual Minorities Uganda, said a group of gay Catholics had written to the public offices of the Vatican asking for a private meeting with the Pope Francis during his stay in the country from November 27th to the 29th. Mugisha, who is a Catholic, said Uganda's threatened lesbian, gay, bisexual and transgender community had been excluded from the Pope's itinerary. The church in Uganda has indicated that it expects the Pope to not discuss gay rights, but Mugisha said he hoped the issue would be raised publicly or privately with the church. The Pope is to visit Uganda on Friday the 27th November for a 3 days visit. South Africa organizes first Transgender Visibility Day in Africa. With more effort being directed to raising awareness of transgender issues in Africa, South Africa is spearheading this long overdue campaign with the very first Transgender Visibility Day. The event will take place on Saturday the 5th of December, has attracted activists from Uganda, Lesotho, Kenya, Namibia, Botswana, and the host country, South Africa. Organized by Eranti, a queer human rights visual media organization based in Johannesburg, the Transgender Visibility Day will be held at the Women's Jail in the Constitution Precinct, Bramfontein, and is expected to run from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Speaking to Mamba Online, the organizer said transgender activists will gather to celebrate International Human Rights Day and engage openly on transgender rights and our social justice work. We call on you to stand with us in fighting homophobia in all its forms and visibilizing the challenges faced by the trans community on our continent. A fundraiser has been set up on Enchant to help collect money that will go to gay activists Binyavanga Wainaina's medical care. The fundraiser, which was set up by Kwani Trust, still has 28 days left to run and has so far raised $2,371. Binyavanga, who is reported to have suffered a stroke recently, has been bedridden for the past couple of weeks, although details about his illness are still scanty. His illness first publicly came to light after he wrote a rather gibberish post on his Facebook page on the 15th of November, raising eyebrows as it was out of his characteristically well-articulated and eloquent self. For any contributions towards this great cause, please visit changa.co.ke to donate. As we wrap up this bulletin, we would like to remind you to submit your stories for the coming issue of Bombastic Magazine, and remember that your article can be written in any language and the deadline still stands at 30th November. You can send a final draft to editor at kuchutimes.com or info@kuchutimes.com. Have a great week.